Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be talking about medical examination for Canada visa process and the documents required that you need to carry when you go for your medical examination. Also, I'll be discussing how you can book your medical examination in this video. So without any further ado, let's get started. So first of all, let me tell you how did I get my medical examination done. I got a request from ISCC on my application for a medical examination for medical checkup, and I need to fulfill that request. I was supposed to fulfill that request within 90 days. So what I did is first of all, we need to go on this link. I'll leave the link in the description box below. You have to go to this link and you need to check your panel physician, which is a panel physician for your particular city. So you need to select the country over here in this particular page in the drop down. After selecting the country, it will show you the list of panels. Like for example, this page will start appearing and you will get the list of panels that are available in your city. Okay, let me show you on the website how it looks like. So this is the link where you have to go and you have to select your country over here. So for example, if I select India and I click on go, then this page will appear which says find a panel physician. So you need to come down and you need to search for your city over here. It is alphabetically present over here. So for example, if I see in Bangalore, Fortis Hospital is there. So what I did next was, after looking at what all panel physicians are being available in this particular listing, I called up the one that is near to my place and I booked an appointment for myself. And after they confirmed the appointment, I went over there with all the required documents. So I'll show you the list of documents which I carried and what all tests were being done. So I'll show you in upcoming slides. So these are some of the documents which I carried with myself. So medical report form IMM 1017E, which will be attached to your medical request letter that you'll be getting from ISCC. And I carried this particular application form. I filled it. Along with that, I carried my original ID card, which is a government issued ID card. So most probably you can take your passport. And eyeglasses or contact lenses if you have those, because there'll be an eye checkup as well. And this is being added latest, that if you are vaccinated, then you need to carry your vaccination certificate or record, and panel physician will make a record of your vaccination status. So this is something newly added. After getting vaccinated, you need to carry that as well. Then what all tests were being done. So once I reached to that hospital where I booked my appointment, the first thing was they made me fill some documents and they checked for my passport. And after filling those documents, I went for a blood test. And after I was done with the blood test, then I went for urine test. Then I went for an eye checkup. In eye checkup, they will just make you read the alphabets, and they'll just ask you to hide one eye, and then they'll ask you to check with the right eye like that. So it's not much, they just want to see that you have vision in your eyes, and if you're carrying your glasses, so they'll make you wear those glasses, and then they'll make you read the board. So it's not too much, like eye checkup. And then there was a physical examination, like your heartbeat, height, weight, and they also did X-ray checkup. So these were some of the tests that were being done. So it is a normal routine checkup. I was a bit skeptical about it since it was about the medical examination, but everything went well and they were quite nice. And all this took me about 2 to 3 hours, since there were a lot of students that day who scheduled their appointment. So you need to go with a lot of preparation in mind, and all these tests will be done on that particular day. And when these tests are being done, the hospital itself will send your report to the ISCC. You don't have to do anything. They will update it on the ISCC. So for my report, it took around 1 week to get updated. I called up the hospital and I just checked once, like why it is not getting updated. So it was updated within a week in my application. and you won't get any extra hard copy or any documents with you because these records are being kept with them. And this particular medical, it is valid for 12 months only. That means if you don't reach Canada as a visitor visa, as if you are on a visitor visa or student or worker visa within that time, then you need to do another examination. Then your medical will expire and you have to give another medical examination. Okay, and you cannot travel after this medical expires. So the validity of this particular medical is 12 months only. So these are some of the points which you can keep in your mind. And so I have already told you what all documents you need to carry, what all test or examination is being done at their end, and it gets updated as well. Now the hospital will directly send the records to IRCC. You don't have to do much over there. So that's it. That was my experience of medical examination for Canada visa application. I hope this video was helpful for you guys. And if you liked my video, please share my video with your friends who are also applying for Canadian visa application, and all the best for your application. Please subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Thank you for watching.